Longquan is situated in the east of China. Here, the sword forging tradition has been passed down for 2,600 years, and it's called Longquan Sword. This stream over here, as small as it seems, plays a very vital role in making Longquan Swords. I came here to learn the sword making process, to hear the old stories of swordsmiths, and also explore the sword culture in China.
In ancient times, swords in China were carried not just for self-defense, but also as a display of social status. The Longquan sword is one of China's most iconic weapons. Historical records tell us that the first iron sword, a Longquan blade, was forged by master smith Ouyezi. Listed as part of the nation's cultural heritage, to this day, Longquan swords are still made by master swordsmiths who follow the ancient forging tradition.
Shen
Xinpei has been making Longquan swords for 60 years and is a national inheritor of the art. He comes from a family that has been forging swords for hundreds of years in the city of Longquan.
铁矿资源，我们这里的铁鹰砂，百分之十五，一百斤泥土里面能够洗炼出15斤。龙船绝大多数都是泥土砂，泥土挖下来放在河里，经过漂洗，沉留下来的就是铁鹰。
The unique combination of minerals found in the local iron sand is what gives the blades their extra resilience and strength. Longquan swordsmiths regularly visit the mountains outside the city to collect iron sand.
Shifu!
Hey!
Hello!
Hey, 你好!
哇，你这里面有多少铁砂？我这里很少了，这样洗出来的话，也就一两两吧。一天的话，我们弄出来大概也就七八斤左右吧。七八斤？对。那你比如说，如果要做一百件的话，大致上要三四十斤铁砂。三四十斤？对。
The heavy part, which is the iron sand, stands on the bottom, and this is how we get the iron sand that is used for sword forging.
我可以试一下吗？可以啊。Okay,
now I really want to try.
蔡，我看你是这样的一个动作，是吧？对对。As early as the 5th century BCE, Chinese smiths when making iron harder using a technique known as carburizing, in which the metal is heated repeatedly. Longquan swords are known for their hard texture and sharp blade, characteristics that are attributed to the forging process. Forging a high-quality blade is a long and complex process. One of the most challenging steps is the hammering. The metal must be heated until it glows yellow, is then beaten into shape on the anvil.
这是一个千层百炼复合锻造的一个过程，所以就是目的把这些，比如说钨的东西，把它排出来，折叠拉长锻造，折叠拉长锻造，复合锻造，把它达到五六千层。
Shen Zhou started learning to make swords from his father, Shen Xinpei, when he was 16 years old.
There's a lot of power.
你这样锻打要多久？
真正练得好的话， 练5到7天吧。
As an old saying goes, forging 100 times turns iron into steel. Repeated heating, folding and forging removes the impurities from the pig iron and eventually produces steel with a firm and dense texture.
刚才看到你们在哪儿打的时候，还有点那个节奏的感觉。对啊，那是一个锤语嘛，因为有时候用嘴巴说话会更累，而且慢。锤语表达一下，大家合作久了都是能体会得到的。刚才我看你拿的是小锤，然后呢，另外一位师傅好像是大的。小锤的话是控制节奏跟我们需要的一些锻造的方法。
Making a Longquan sword blade weighing a kilogram requires a 3 to 5 kilogram piece of pig iron, which must be hammered tens of thousands of times. The sight of the sparks flying like fireworks is mesmerizing, so I just had to give it a go.
And it feels so good!
这样砸是错误的，应该是砸了之后往回收，往下打。啊，荡，对，这样荡。对。No,
but actually it felt really good. Like now I see why there's so many people in America, in Europe, and they do it as a hobby. Actually, it's like you're releasing energy, and it feels really relaxing.
它是你只要准心控好，这个手是可以放松一点的，砸了之后往收才用力，这样的话就会省力了。Technical
limitations in ancient times meant the carbon content of steel remained low. Quenching was imperative for improving the blade's rigidity, hardness, tenacity, and resistance to abrasion. The blade, once it reaches a temperature of 750 to 800 degrees centigrade, is plunged into water to cool. The ability to choose precisely the right moment for cooling the steel is what sets a master apart from an ordinary smith. Traditionally, producing a Longquan sword involves more than 20 processes, many of which are dependent on the experience of the smith. Making a single sword can take several months, even years. By the 7th century AD, swords were gradually being replaced by new weapons on the battlefield. As their military use declined, they began to assume greater cultural significance.
From a sword's perspective, it's not the same. 你看，埃及的正女神一手天平一手剑嘛， 也是正义、公平、公正，跟中国的是一模一样的。从这个剑的层次上来说和精神上来说，是我们的祖先不约而同把剑提高到一至高无上的地位，权力的象征啊，
权力象征，
这剑的正能量的这个方面，它就体现得很突出啊，仗剑走江湖。
Compared to the sabers, rapiers, and cutlasses that were commonly seen in the West, Chinese swords were distinct in their appearance. More importantly, they had a richer cultural connotation.
In our Tang Dai, the time, 文武百官都佩剑，佩剑显尊贵，仗义走江湖，人要德才兼备，剑同样是德才兼备，人的才就是你的才能，剑的才是什么呢？剑术是百兵之王，百兵之君。
For aristocrats and officials, a sword was an important accessory that reflected its owner's status. This explains the enduring popularity of Longquan swords. With a high quality, distinctive design and fame, they were presented as tribute to emperors and high-ranking officials and given as gifts among friends. Hu Xiaojun is today one of Longquan's most renowned swordsmiths. His ancestors moved to the city over 1,000 years ago.
A great work must have a design.特别是一般好的东西，它的成本很贵啊，它不会轻易下手。
You know, that sounds like a story about a Mozart. Like when those really famous musicians, they hear the melody in their mind, and they, for them, they just record it on the paper.
我学电子专业，但是现在，全部心思都用在我们最古老的工艺上面，看的祖祖辈辈做的宝剑，所以从小。在我们的血骨血里面就传承着这种铸剑的基因。
Hu Xiaojun is passionate about tradition and has revived many of China's ancient swords, along with the techniques of making them.
这个就是饕餮纹，我们会传承我们最古老的一些纹饰用在我们的剑上面。皇家的东西都非常的华丽，你包括它的玉具的装具。铁的装具，还有银的装具等等哈，它都会溜金溜银，它的工艺会非常的复杂。像我们现在用的这个设备，就是用新的设备结合传统的，它就可以雕得很细腻，工艺就会比原来古人还要好。这样子，你看这一部分经过一雕，它如果再下去，它肉就可以往下掉了。
It looks like a tool that they use in the dental clinic.
对，它其实最早是用在牙医上面。
哦，真的。
我们把它用到了铁上面。
Back when smelting techniques weren't sufficiently developed to extract metal from iron ore, pure iron was unobtainable. The only place it might be found was in meteorite. Hu Xiaojun is very passionate about this heaven-sent metal. Though it's difficult to work with, he has managed to forge a few meteorite iron swords. Understandably, these are highly prized collector's items.
This two swords are what we are building, a Longquan Sword,
Longquan Sword. What is Longquan
Sword? A husband, a wife. Oh. Longquan Sword. Because the sword is a two-edged, one edge, two-edged, it can protect itself and kill enemies. For the celebration of the marriage day, they want to build a sword of love.
This is the first time I hear that swords have that kind of relationship. But so this one is probably designed for a husband, this is for wife. Not for fighting. But when you say it in Chinese, it actually sounds like love from the first sight.
This is a sword that can be transferred. Like this is from outer space, the sky, the sky. It's older than the age of the Earth, 46 million years. So, this kind of couple combination represents an eternal love.
There's evidence that Chinese smiths were using metal from meteorites to make swords several millennia ago. In Jun County, Henan Province, a bronze blade dating from the Shang Dynasty has been found, containing 6 to 10% nickel. This indicates that meteorite iron was smelted with copper.
这个就是我们传说中的天铁，来自外太空，来自天上的天铁。这个叫做维斯台登纹，是经过亿万年慢慢的冷却形成的铁镍结晶。它这种机理是在特定的环境和特定的时间温度才能形成这样子的铁镍结晶。你看，交错纵横的机理，这种机理的话，是我们现在科技无法还原的。 也是我们人类一直在探寻的宇宙的起源。我们可以放大哦，
。
再放大啊。
Look at those lines over there. Look, oh my gosh.
那交错纹理，它是非常的复杂的。Working
with meteorite iron is far more complex than with traditional metals. But the finished blade is easier to wield and more durable, partly thanks to the nickel it contains. Smiths have been using this metal from the sky to make weapons for hundreds of years. Numerous such items have been unearthed, dating from as early as the 36th century BCE up to the 11th century AD.
所以你一锻打到空，它就裂开，就像冰一样。 一锻打就裂开，所以从工艺上面，它是极难的一种工艺，
难度最高的工艺。那么第二个呢，它的材料，它跟百炼钢完全不一样，因为它是来自外星球，它具有很多我们地球上所有我们见不到的一些特征。哇 ，Look at that pattern on the edge. It's something out of this world, literally.
来，我们看一下这个剑在显微镜下面哈。
Man, it's like a painting.
它就自带的，科技无法还原它，它一定是天铁纯天铁打出来的。先看一下这个，我们这个是百炼钢的。
When you look at these waves, these are actually different layers of different metals, like soft metals and rigid metals, and when you know they're together, it's like just so much better for the sword. So it's more agile and it's more firm.
Wanting to explore more properties of meteoric iron, Hu Xiaojun tried combining it with other materials. This led him to discover another universe.
So he said, like, the meteorite, metal, and the ceramics.
Those galaxies there.
一个宇宙.
No, look at those suns and planets and
真的像太阳, 像这个银河呀, 像,
每个星系,
星系,
漂亮, 你看,
哦, 真的好美,
嗯, 再来啊,
哇, 哇, oh, whoa, look at that small.
Oh, I see. So the metal melted, and when it reached really high temperature, it turned into different colors. But this is like, man, I can look at this for hours.
它能改变水质，我们有很多的检测报告，发现它所有的指向对人体都很好。到我们现在研究了四年多了。
越研究越不可思议，每一个杯子都不一样，而且都是一个宇宙。胡老师，但是为什么您会这么喜欢用天铁做宝剑？就未知的这种属性，激发我更大的动力往前走。所以在这个过程中，让我有更多的动力去研究古人的工艺。
Like Hu Xiaojun, other Longquan smiths have for centuries been striving to impart more traditional culture through their swords. As a result, Longquan swords have long been sought after by not only martial artists, but also art collectors. In Chinese martial arts culture, swords are thought to be alive and to have a soul. Like a loyal friend, they protect their master. Therefore, scholars and poets also carried swords, not as weapons, but as companions. The most famous among them were the philosopher Confucius and the Tang Dynasty poet Li Bai.
武剑其实在中国，首先是历史非常的悠久。其实最早来说的话，跟祭祀有关，然后后来可能跟战争有关。战争之前有一种仪式，包括有祭祀的这种精神上的寄托，所以他会把这个就是附诸于这样的一个道具上面。
There's an old saying in China that a fine dance has to have fine props. This is why dancers in China are often seen holding something. Whatever is in their hands enhances the message they want to convey.
中国人一旦拿起剑，我认为都会心中会产生一些。 想象 最精彩的其实是在 唐代杜甫写了一首诗叫关公孙大娘舞剑器，昔有佳人公孙氏，一舞剑器动四方。所以说他在当时他描绘了一个社会上的一个风貌、嗯、然后包括唐三绝，李白的诗、嗯、裴明的剑舞，还有张旭的草书、啊、哇哦！所以这个剑舞在当时的文人的这个生活里面应该是非常重要的一个构成、嗯、今天我们用剑其实也是在为了还原历史、嗯去追溯历史。
As a leading traditional dance artist, Hu Yang has portrayed many prominent historical figures. His most popular subjects are Confucius and Li Bai.
In this 5句 Kongzi, we want to make the剑塑造成一个就文化的标识性的东西。中国也讲止戈为武嘛，就如何把这个兵器的东西转换成一个礼仪的语言。这也是孔子对剑的理解。那么到了李白，其实是以剑作笔，用剑在书写他的诗歌。嗯，
我才必有用，千金散尽还复来。
啊，你觉得就是舞剑哈、啊、跟文学这个融合，它是怎么样的一个融合？
首先是这样，剑它也不是独立存在的，它在文化里。在我们的艺术作品的创作中呢，把这些的文化的素材融入进来，最后完成一个作品，它有它的这个文化的符号，所以它对这个人物的塑造非常重要。
这个舞剑这些动作其实除了好看之外，它其实想表达过去的一些精神或者一些社会地位之类的。
对，其实它是由内而外来传递某一种讯息，艺术最后还要把归于到文化的内容上面去，最后是精神的体现，最后能传递出这个像剑这个符号的精神，这个人物的精神。
We can learn so much from the swordsmith of Longquan. The patience, the diligence, they put so much of their soul into each blade they make, despite the probability of failure. The more I think about it, the more I realize that they not only forge their long-lasting swords, they forge a long-lasting tradition that enriches both China and the whole world.